Welcome back, children. I hope you have gone through the worksheets, previous worksheets, and you have done the worksheets. Now it's we have finished till page number 9, and now it's page number 10. Worksheet number 10. So in that worksheet, that is to add an apostrophe and rewrite the sentences. That is, when you say something belongs to someone, we will put an apostrophe to show that that thing belongs to someone. For example, Raja's shirt. The shirt of Raja is called Raja's shirt. We can say in short form, Raja's shirt. So we will write Raja apostrophe S shirt. Okay, so like that, here some sentences are given. You have to convert it by adding apostrophe to it. See, look here. The poem written by Veena. What do you call the poem written by Veena? Veena's poem. So see, Veena apostrophe S poem. Okay, then Alka. The house of Alka. What do you call the house of Alka? Alka's house. So Alka apostrophe S house. Alka's house. Then the court of magician. Court of magician is magician apostrophe S court. Magician's court. The den of the lion is called the lion's den. Lion apostrophe S den. Then the nose of the clown. Clown apostrophe S nose. Clown's nose. Then the shoes of Raman. Shoes of Raman. Raman apostrophe S shoes. Then the tail of the monkey. Monkey apostrophe S tail. Now here this one, there is a slight difference. So usually we used to put the apostrophe after the word. So here the ninth one is the hat of James. What do you call James? It's already ending in S. Okay, James, J-A-M-E-S. It's ending in S. So what happens is, again we need not write James apostrophe S, no need to write. It will become James's. No need of that. So we will, if a word is ending in S, we will put the apostrophe after S. Okay, James apostrophe hat. The hat of James, James hat. That's enough. There is no need of adding an apostrophe S and then S again. So James hat. If it is Mr. Das hat or Mr. Das pen, how will you do it? Mr. Das, already ending in S. So Mr. Das apostrophe pen. There is no need of adding Das S. Again S, no need. So if a word is ending in S, just put the apostrophe after that. Is that clear? Then the pen of Nina. Nina apostrophe S pen. Nina's pen. So that is how we use the apostrophe, and that was page number 10 of the Toy Horse worksheet. I hope that this is clear to you. Now the page number 11 of your worksheet. Change the first letter of the underlined words to make true sentences. That is what is given. Change the first letter of the underlined word to make true sentences. Fish swim in cake. Will the fish swim in cake? No, the fish will not swim in cake. Then where does it swim? It swims in a lake. The fish swim in lake. Fish swim in, not cake, lake. First letter you have to change and make lake. Cake, lake. Okay. The sun shines in the sky. Is it fun? No, it is the sun shines in the sky. The sun shines in the sky. It's cold today, so wear your packet. Is it packet? No, it is jacket. So it is cold today, so you have to wear your jacket, not packet. Then the log barks loudly. Is it the log that is barking? No, it is the dog barks loudly. Then the bat is sitting on the chair. Is it the bat is sitting on the chair? What is it? It will be. It is the cat is sitting on the chair. Not bat. Cat is sitting on the chair. It is written there bat, but not bat. Cat is sitting on the chair. That was page number 11. You have to change these words like this and write it neatly down. Okay. Now in page number 11 itself, you can see homophones. You might have already known this. Homophones are two or more words having same pronunciation but different meaning. The homophones are words that having same pronunciation. We pronounce the same. When we tell it, this it will be the same. But the spelling will be different and also it will have a different meaning. One example I can tell is N-E-W, new. What is the meaning of new? New means a new thing. A thing which was bought very new. Okay, new. And another new also is the K-N-E-W is also pronounced as new. So, when we hear it in English, it is the same. But the spelling you just see, the spelling is different and both are having different meanings. Such words are called homophones. Homophones are words that have different meaning but same pronunciation. Not spelling but same pronunciation. They are called the homophones. Now look at the exercise given. Match the following. You have to match with the words which are having same pronunciation. W-A-I-T, weight. W-A-I-T, weight is the. And W-E-I-G-H-T, weight is also there. D-E-A-R, deer. And D-E-E-R, deer is there. D-E-A-R and D-E-E-R. Throne. T-H-R-O-N-E, throne. And T-H-R-O-W and thrown out. Okay. T-H-R-O-N-E, T-H-R-O-W-N also is there. Then K-N-O-T-E, note, and N-O-T-E, note. To note. It both are pronounced same but meanings are different. Spelling also different. R-I-G-H-T, right. W-R-I-T-E, right. Both right and right. H-O-L-E, hole, and W-H-O-L-E, hole. Okay, so these are the words which are given in your worksheets. Please match it according to the pronunciation. This is also page number 11. Okay. Page number 11. Now coming to the next page, page number 12, in that a passage, a small passage is given in which the punctuations are not correct. You know the punctuation means capital letter, full stop, other marks like exclamation mark or any other questions are the question mark. All these are called the punctuation marks. Here you have to see only the capital letters and full stop. One small passage is given. I will just read the passage. You go through the passage. In a village, there lives a little girl. She is very brave. Once the villagers hear a bell ring, they are scared The brave girl goes into the forest. She finds that some monkeys are ringing the bell. She tells the villagers about it. They thank her and rewarded her. This is a small passage. You know the story. So, how will you write it? Now, you have to write it in the correct way. That is, starting with capital letter. See, in, I capital, in, I, in a village, there lives a little girl. After that, full stop should be there. She is very brave. S capital, and after that, there should be a full stop. Once the villagers hear a bell ring. So, once, O capital, the villagers hear a bell ring. Full stop. They are scared. Of course, it should start, T should start with capital letter. They are scared and there should be a full stop here. The brave girl goes into the forest. The first letter capital, T capital. Forest, full stop. After forest, full stop should be there. She finds that some monkeys are ringing the bell. So, she, S should be capital. Some monkeys are ringing the bell. After bell, full stop should be there. She tells the villagers about it. S again capital, and after the sentence, there should be full stop. They thank her and rewarded her. T also again capital letter. Thank her and rewarded her. Okay, full stop. So, see that in the beginning of every sentence, the first letter should be capital. And remember to put a full stop after every sentence. Okay, and this worksheet, you have to write it very neatly into your worksheet, touching the lines carefully. Touch the lines carefully and copy it. Okay, so with that, we come to the end of the 12th worksheet also. Then next we have worksheet number 13. Worksheet number 13 is, the first exercise is to complete the sentence using A, E, I, O, U. Okay, using A, E, I, O, U. And you know what is A, E, I, O, U? Have you heard of A, E, I, O, U before? Yes, you know it is the vowels. I know you all know very well that A, E, I, O, U are called the vowels. So, with the vowels, it's very easy for you to do. Okay, the first one, C dash T, C A T cat, B dash N, yes, B U N bun, T dash P, T A P tap. I know you have already done it. Okay, it's very easy for you, I know. L dash G, L O G log, T dash B, yes, T U B tub. F dash dash D, it is F O O D food. Then M dash G, M U G mug. Okay, D dash G, D O G dog. Okay, C dash W, C O W cow. Here there are two dashes are there. B O O K book. Okay, B O O K book. These are the words. I hope you got it. Using A E I O U, you will come across these type of words. You know all these words, very simple words. I hope it is easy for you. This one also very easy for you to do. Match correctly. What does a doctor, cobbler, postman, policeman do? You already know all these things, okay? So, let's match it. A doctor, yes, cures patients. A cobbler, what is a cobbler? Makes shoe. Postman, of course, gives letters. And a policeman catches thieves. I hope all of you got it. Okay, I want all of you to write all these worksheets. You have to copy the notes. You have to write it neatly. And I hope you all will study the things which are given. Okay, thank you.